Hello everyone. So I have put so many videos regarding diabetic wound care management. This is one such a video regarding a nutritional requirement when it comes for wound care management. So many of our patients won't have adequate nutrition, particularly elderly. So we need to emphasize the nutritional importance for such patient, and we have to give in a simpler form so that patient can understand what is the protein, what is the carbohydrate, all this in a simpler form. So particularly when we classify nutrition when in terms of wound management, there are macronutrients as well as micronutrients. Macronutrients are carbohydrates, proteins and fat. So carbohydrates, diet which are rich in carbohydrate, are rooted vegetables, cereals and fruits like banana, mangoes. So this generally for diabetic patient, carbohydrate should be reduced so that the glycemic level is maintained at the normal range. And protein they need to take in a adequate quantity, because the exudates from the wound mostly are protein rich. So the loss of these proteins has to be managed with proper supplementation. So diet which are rich in proteins are dal, paneer, nuts, chana, and in non-vegetarian source are skinless chicken and fish, egg white. So these things has to be told to the patient to take in adequate quantity. And fat, they should have a normal fat diet. When it comes for micronutrients, vitamin A, C, zinc, selenium, iron are very essential for wound improvement, because vitamin A, we all know vitamin A are rich in papaya, carrot. So this is very essential for during inflammatory phase of wound healing as well as epithelialization, and it boosts the immune system also. And vitamin C is also equally important. It is very important in collagen cross-linking, and it also boosts up the immune response. And vitamin C is very rich in citrus fruits, we all know, like lemon, orange, all these things are having adequate vitamin C content. And vitamin B complex are rich in pomegranate, beetroot. This is very essential in RBC formation. Along with that, micronutrients, zinc, selenium are also contribute, they are antioxidant, they also contribute in wound healing. So macronutrients are as well as micronutrients, along with proper glycemic control, very good culture sensitive antibiotic, proper debridement, and good psychological support, and good bed rest, offloading, all these things are very important, and it's a combined approach when it comes for wound healing. Thanks for watching. See you. Bye bye.